let's discuss restrictive cardiomyopathies. In restrictive cardiomyopathies, the walls of the heart are rigid, but they're not thickened. As you see in this picture, we have heart muscles. It may appear to be a little bit large in this drawing. However, this is a normal size, what we're looking at here. What we're dealing with, however, is a restriction specifically more common in the atrium. So we can see a bilateral atrial thickening and a restriction of the ventricles. So this leads us to a diastolic dysfunction due to a lack of the ability for those ventricles to stretch and fill with blood properly, and then under a normal systole, eject a normal cardiac output worth of blood. We can see a restrictive cardiomyopathy in Loeffler endocarditis. Loeffler endocarditis is a response to a parasitic infection, and we see it associated with a hypereosinophilic syndrome. So we have a lot of eosinophils responding to this parasitic infection, and so the histology will show up and show eosinophilic infiltrates in the myocardium, leading to that restriction. So what are the possible causes of cardiomyopathies, restrictive cardiomyopathies? Well, we can use the mnemonic puppy leash. And on puppy leash, we use the P of puppy and then all the letters of leash. So the P stands for post-radiation fibrosis. So a radiation of any type in the chest area can cause a restrictive cardiomyopathy that may potentially affect the pericardium as well. The L we just mentioned was Loeffler's endocarditis. The E in leash is endocardial fibroelastosis. This is a thick fibroelastic tissue of the endocardium in young children. Amyloidosis can cause a restrictive cardiomyopathy. Alongside of that, sarcoidosis can cause a restrictive cardiomyopathy. And then another one, hemochromatosis, can cause a restrictive cardiomyopathy due to the deposition of the iron into the muscle fibers there. Treatment of a restrictive cardiomyopathy is a little bit difficult because there's really no treatment for the actual restriction. We just treat the causative conditions. So if a patient has amyloidosis or sarcoidosis or hemochromatosis, we're going to go back and we're going to treat those the way that they need to be treated and help reduce the restrictive effects on the heart.